Time is almost here, and you might be looking to find that perfect dish to cook when you fire up your grill on Sunday. And if you like trying to eat healthy as well, trying to stick those New Year's resolutions, we're bringing both together. We're going to marry both with Longhorn Steakhouse grill master, Matt Bellina. So thanks for being here.
Well, thanks for having me. Yeah, as part of the New Year's resolution, a lot of people are choosing lighter options. So over at Longhorn Steakhouse, we have a new blackened salmon that we grill there. It's fresh, never frozen. We sear it to perfection. So we're going to walk through the process on how we do that and how you can replicate that at home. So
awesome.
This is our salmon right here.
It's a chunky piece.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
So leave the skin on it. We're going to grill it.
Yes, and the reason you want to leave the skin on it is it helps keep the fish together so it doesn't fall apart.
Makes sense.
Other fish that are great for that, tuna is a good one. Swordfish is a good one. Probably want to stay away from fish like maybe a flounder because it's very thin. It'll cook real fast, and then the process usually falls apart.
Okay.
Okay, so another recommendation while you're doing this is you want to make sure that you use a spatula, not tongs, because as the fish cooks up, it's very delicate and it will start to break apart, okay? So one thing you want to do is make sure that your pan is very hot, okay, and that you use a lot of oil.
Okay.
You want to have that oil because that will help sear in the seasoning on top. So what we do at Longhorn is we are known for boldly seasoning, of course. So what we do is we take our seasoning, go all the way down and all the way back up, and we call that a round trip.
Oh.
It's great for one, it gets that extra seasoning in there, and for two, sometimes in the process, some of the seasoning falls out. So if you want to,
oh, that's a lot.
Yeah, it comes up. No, listen, you can't go wrong.
Like,
actually, you can't go wrong because watch how much seasoning I'm gonna put on there. You're gonna go all the way down, and you're gonna go all the way back.
Okay.
So
that's
look
how,
yeah, that's how much is. And then one thing you're gonna do is pat that in so that it gets in there, and then you'll take your oil, you'll put a lot of oil in the pan. Now you're always going to put this what we call meat side down. So you'll take this salmon, put it down like this, and let it cook.
Awesome.
And one recommendation with it is don't play with it. You want to cook it till about 75% on the side. So for a piece of fish about 1 inch thick, you're looking at about 5 minutes.
Great tips.
So then after you cook that for 5 minutes, then you'll use your spatula to flip it, so that way that you don't tear it apart, and then you'll cook it the rest of the way on the other side. You're really looking for an internal temperature of about 145 degrees.
Okay, awesome. Well, we got about a minute left. So in the magic of TV, this is the finished product?
That's the finished product. So that's how
Beautiful.
It comes out. You can see how blackened and how rich that looks there.
Mm-hmm.
Gives a great flavor. It's just something awesome that you could do. You could do it at home. At Longhorn, we do it on a flat top grill, but any saute pan will be great for you. Just make sure, again, you use those oils and the seasoning.
Okay. So want to add some side dishes here?
Yeah,
it's always
absolutely.
Good to
you
have
can always
some
go light. We put the salmon on some rice. It's also good to finish it off with a little melted butter. It helps add to those spices and helps seal in the flavor. You know, so that's great for a lighter option, but you know, you can't go wrong with steak. So if you want to come down to the Longhorn, we have great steaks there, great steaks for grilling. A good tip for your grilling for this Super Bowl Sunday is just make sure you can't use enough seasoning. So put that seasoning on there thick, especially if you're cooking on a char grill. It's going to fall off some of it, and make sure your grill's really hot to sear it in.
Okay.
And then finish it off with a butter. It really seals in that flavor.
Some excellent tips there from Grill Master Bellina at Longhorn Steakhouse. So appreciate you being here this morning. And, of course, for those of us who have fallen off the wagon, I will be choosing this one in the break. Thank you so much.
Well, thanks for having me.
All right, folks, stick around because coming up,